Hello, good evening everyone. I'm Faris Abdallah Ghamdi in Blue Team. And now I present my teammate, Samir Abdulaziz Marghalani and Yazid Ali. Today, inshallah, we'll talk about three topics or four. It's important for us and important for our life. And now, in project any life you will do it, and I hope this presentation you like it, and let's go the next slide, please, Samir. This our agenda style. We'll talk about it. First, we'll talk about calculating float slack schedule, and also we'll talk about the general of the default schedule, the input and output and tools and techniques. And the second, Samir will talk about the agenda chart of our project. And third, Yazid will talk about defined project activities. Next slide, Samir. here we'll talk about what's the input of default schedule and what the tools or techniques for this develop schedule to get the output. Every topics here in this course, you must have three main parts. First, the box about the input here, and the tools or techniques to do this in this input to get the output. Three box: input, tools and techniques to get output. Here in both, as you see, we have project management plan, include schedule management plan and scope baseline. This is important to project management plan. Second, project document. Yazid here will explain more details about this, about activities, attributes and active list and assumption log, and as you see here, and you have project schedule network diagram and project team assessment and the resource calendars and the resource requirement, and finally risk register. And three, here we have agreement. And four, in input, we have interface, environmental factors. And five, we have organizational process assist. This input for develop schedule. What are the tools and techniques for this input to get the output? The tools or techniques for this input is schedule network analysis and critical path method. Critical path is very important for any project or any work you do in our life. Not just for project, any plan you want to get and you want to be ready for this, you must have critical path method. Is the most important for this graph. And the three here, resources of optimization we have. And four, we have a data analysis. The data analysis include what if and simulation. And five, here we have leads and lags. And six, we have schedule compression. Seven, also we have project management information system. Eight, we have releases planning. And the finally, about this output, we have schedule baseline. Two, you must have project schedule, you must have schedule data, you must have project calendars, you have change request, it's very important. And six, we have project management plan update. What you do in update what you have a face in your project and schedule management plan and cost baseline include this in six. And seven, we have project document updates that you see it present us and what the output for this. It's a activity attributes, assuming assumption log and derivation is metric and lesson learned register. And resources requirement, and finally, risk register. That's what we have here in the develop schedule, what the input and the tools and techniques, and the output for this. And next slide, please, Samir. Okay, now let's talk about important thing. Now let's talk about the schedule for this and the chart for calculating flows, slack, and schedule. In here, we have a circle, mini part to explain to you must understand this. First, what's the meaning for this a symbol A or B or anything? This, the meaning of active name is, this is the active name or symbol. They must have up for the circle, and you see you have a right and left thing here. In the right, as you see, EFT. What's the meaning about EFT? If you know, EFT, it's a meaning or it's a realized finish time, okay? And the left we have in the up, not down, in the up. In the up we have the EST. What's the EST? It's the earliest start time. Well, the earliest start time for this goal or this work or this what you do here in this active name. And down we have two things. We have LST and LFT. In left thing, LST is latest start time. And in right thing, latest finish time, it's meaning LFT. And here we have number two, and this the active duration. What the start time and the end time will take long about this active. And as you see here also in the right picture, we have here start and the finally you have end. Every active you do or every work you do, you have active and end for this. And as you see red line. This the auras show a relationship between every active and every work together. Is the relationship about maybe here in the example D and G. What's the relationship about D and G? You must finish D to go to G. And for example, also A and C. You must finish A to you can't go to D and C. You can't go to D or C if you don't finish A. And finally, H here also. You can't go to active this and do this work if you don't finish F and G and E and C and D and B and A. It's very important. Don't make later we do, no, this professional work. Please focus about this. Now we'll move next slide to see the example here. What's the example here to do this? First, calculating flow slack schedule. What's the question here first? Which path is the critical path? We must here know what the critical path. And second, what is the float slack of active H? And what is the float slack of activity F? And for what is the float slack of activity B? This four things we know here. Okay, as you see here, if you see the four things, which path is the critical path, and what is the float slack of the activity H, and what is the float slack of activity F, and what is the float slack of activity B. As you see here, you must know what the start. Start is, please give me next slide. Start here, as you see, everything is zero. And you see the table here, you have active A and B and C and D and E, F and F and G and H and I. This was the route in the draft before, okay? And the limited reduced store A is zero, okay? And B also is nothing, and C is nothing, and D it's B here. You can't if you do D, you must finish the B, and if you do the E, if you do the E here, you must finish A and C. If you please send me the next slide to understand the before slide, please before. Oh yeah, here. As you see here, E, as you see here, E, you must finish A and C to go to E. And also D, you must finish B to go to D. Next slide. This is the second column here. And here, the rotation for every active. And active A, the rotation for this is 3 days, and B, it's 4 and C is 2. Just by calculating here, as you see here in square A, you have 3 in earliest finish time and 3 in the last finish time and earliest start time. And earliest start time, least start time is 0, 0, because before it started, all of them it's 0. And we calculated about this, what is the rotation and what is the ES and what is the EF, and also what is the LS and LF and slack here. After we finish calculating for this, as you see here in critical path, we have repeated here, 3-3, repeated about EFT and LFT. And I start 0, 0 and A 3, 3 in LFT and EFT, sorry, and LFT and H 19 in earliest finish time and 19 in latest finish time. And as you see here in E, we have also earliest finish time and latest finish time. It's also 8, 8. Because that we have the critical path A and E and H. And the answer about question 2, what is the float slack of active H? If you see here, the active H is 0. The slack for this, it's 0, okay? Because 19 minus 19, will get 0, 19 minus 19 here, you will get 0. And the answer for question 3, what's the active for F? As you see here in here in F, 11 minus 5, you will get 6. And here in F, please Samir, show about your mouse in F, watch your mouse. Yeah, and if, as you see here, in EF, we have 5 here. In EF, we have 5. And in LF, we have 11. 11 minus 5, you'll get 6 slack. And also in active, question 4, the answer about this is 5 in activity B. Activity B, as you see in EF, 4. And LF 9 minus 4, you will get 5. And this, every slack of activity we get it here for answer 2 and answer 3 and answer 4. And also you'll get the answer for critical path and why it's critical path and EFH. I will repeat it because the 3 and 3 is the same and 19 is the same and 8 and the 8 is the same because that is there is the critical path. I hope I answered this question very clear And very good. Thank you, gentlemen. Now I will move with Samir to continue the Jant chat. Thank you.
Thank you, my colleague. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum. My name is Yazid Al-Hiani, and I'm going to talk about define activities. What is define activities process? In order to complete a project, a certain set of activities must be performed by the project team. Members of defined activities is the process of identifying and documenting the specific actions to be performed to produce the project deliverables. During defined activities process, based on the determined scope, activities that must be performed to reach the project goals and objectives are defined. These activities are usually as small as to be completed in hours or in days. Because these activities will be performed by project team members, and they should be as small as possible in order to manage and project and to manage a project better. Work package are broken down into activities in order to be better estimated, scheduled, monitored, and managed. Work packages show a small interim deliverables or work that need to be completed, but activities are small parts of each work package. The work package can be completed by completing all activities belong to it. Breaking down the work packages to activities will have better and more accurate estimation, managing and coordination in a project. Respectively, because each activity will be very small, like an installation of a PC, development of a sample screen, etc. And the sign of these activities will be more confident during the estimation. Next, we have the inputs and the outputs. In the inputs, we have a project management plan, which includes the schedule management plan and scope baseline. Second, you have the enterprise environment factors. Third, you have organizational process assist. For the tools and techniques, we have expert judgment, decomposition. Third, we have rolling wave planning. Fourth, we have meetings. The outputs will be activity list, activity interviews, milestone list, change requests. Fifth, we have the project management plan updates. This will be in schedule baseline and cost baseline. The expert judgment expertise should be considered from individuals or groups with specialized knowledge or training in the following topics: business analysis, requirements allocation, requirements analysis, requirements documentation, project requirements in previous similar projects, diagramming techniques, facilitation, conflict management. The decomposition is the primary tool of the process of creating WBS and project scope management. Decomposition will break down deliverables and small enough components to be considered as a work package. The work packages are then used to work efforts, cost, and time estimation. The work packages will need to be further decomposed into activities and then tasks later on for accurate time estimation with activity sequencing. Next, we have rolling wave planning. Is a project management technique that involves progressive elaboration and to add detail to work breakdown structure. WBS on an ongoing basis. Shortening time will be by two methods, by making it possible for productive activities to begin without waiting for a detail of the project work to be determined in advance. Second, we have by eliminating downtime for additional planning in the middle of the of a project, since planning is done continuously. The activity list. The activity list is simply a place to log all the activities. The list presents the activity number or identifier, the name of the activity, and the detailed description of the activity. We have three ways to have it, or three musts we have. We need to have it. The activities should be of a size and complexity that allow to be reliability estimated. Second, we have the responsibility for the activities should be clear out. Third, the activity should be measurable. Let's have a look on the activity list. Here is the activity list. We have the task name and the under with the every activity with it. For example, we have the here develop project charter. We can notice here the meetings will be with us on all the tasks, because it's a teamwork, and every activity should be agreed with the team and work with the team. For example, if I've developed the project charter, you need to have a meeting and write a report of the findings. For identify stakeholders, we have to have meeting, collect and identify stakeholders, write a report of founding. And the development project management plan, have an agreement on a plan. These activities is the small structure of the tasks. So tasks is a major title. Under this task, we have activities to do. These activities will help us achieve the tasks. Another example, here, collect requirements. We need to have a meeting, as we said, and get requirements listed. Then write a report of findings, and it go on and on and on with all the tasks. Let's go back to the. Activity attributes. Specific components of a particular activity are known as activity attributes. In the beginning, these are typically descriptive factors related to the specific activity, but they can also describe activities that will become more relevant later in the project timeline. Most activity attributes can be organized, sorted, and summarized. This happens based on a few specific categories. A few of the categories for activity attributes are activity codes. The specific people involved in the activity locations for the activity, the time and cost required for a compilation, etc. It helps to organize the activity attributes into similar categories. Let's see the activity attributes for our project. Basically, the activity attributes is like the WBS dictionary. We have here the activity meeting. Have team meetings to discuss and agree on findings. Report of findings. Findings should be reported to be achieved. Collect and identify the stakeholders. Stakeholders should be identified and listed. Have an agreement on a plan. The dictionary said the plan should be settled in early time, and the team should agree on it. You can see it's like the WBS dictionary. Describe what is the activity in more details. Get a requirement listed. The content should be agreed and listed in the right way. Flow chart of WBS. WBS need to be clear in the formal way and agreed on. Settle down a schedule. Schedule should be followed and agreed on. Have a budget, a final budget that is realistic and suitable with the project. and it go on and on and on with all the activities. Let's go back to the presentation. Milestone. Milestone is an event in a project that is a benchmark in the project. And milestones have some things that make it special than others. Milestones will have zero duration. Also, milestones have no resources assigned. And milestones will be used as benchmarks to measure progress associated with external constraints. There are two types of milestones with respect to time and with respect to importance, like mandatory and optional. So we are dealing with milestones. We need to put it in the right type. In time, we will have the start and finish, and the importance, we have the mandatory and optional. This will help us to deal with it without risk, without taking risks. Or change the plan if it is needed. For our project, we have here the project approval. It is mandatory. We have the requirements review, which is also mandatory. We have also final approval. It's also a mandatory. Now back to my colleague.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Good morning, gentlemen. My name is Samir. Thank you to my friend Faris. Today, I would like to start with three parts in Jitter chart. Okay, first one is the definition of Jitter chart. Then I will talk about the task, the relation between the task. Okay, then I will present our Jitter chart for our project, which is the snake blocker. Okay, let's first talk about Jitter chart and explain it more. Okay, okay. When someone mentioned Gantt chart, some people might think of old fashioned separate sheet, but they couldn't be more wrong. Why? Because Gantt chart are great in this article. You will find a complete guide to understanding the effectiveness of Gantt chart of your project. Regardless of what kind of industry you're working. Gantt chart are commonly used for tracking project schedule, and they are especially useful in project management. To put it simple, they literate and allow to know what needs to be done and when it needs to be done. Gantt chart are also able to show your additional information regarding the different tasks or section of a project, such as how far have the task progresses, how a group of tasks might depend or other group of tasks. How important several tasks are and are being used within a project or what. One of the greatest thing about Gantt chart is that they are extremely extremely visual. On the left side of Gantt chart, you will find a list of tasks necessary for a project. And the top in the Gantt chart, you will find the time scale. Here comes the important part, which is each task is represented by a bar. Its length represented the duration of the task. At the same time, each bar is represented the title of the activity that needs to be completed, along with any relevant information that will help carry it to completion. Okay, now let's that will be, bring to us in mind, do we need Gantt chart in our project? This is a simple question, because all you need to know is whether or not you have a project that needs to be done. If you have a project that you are working on getting completed, and especially if you are working with a team of any kind, you need a Gantt chart. In fact, even if you are working on a project internally solo, you may still need a Gantt chart, because it's going to help you flash out your project into all different components. It's a whole lot more than that. However, these charts were originally designed to make planning and execution of a project easier. And as they have continued to evolve, the process has only continued to get easier. You can use Gantt chart no matter what type of project you are working on, or just how you are working on progressive in your business. Creating and executing a project is the in the right way is going to make a huge difference for you so make sure that you are paying attention for all the different things that you are your Gantt chart can do. All you need to make is to make sure that you are using the right one, and that you are using is to facilitate extent possible. Okay, some of the most important features you should be looking for are: one, task and workload management, time and progress tracking, dependencies and milestones. Four, we have the team collaboration. Okay, these features allow you the most control over everything related to your businesses and your specific projects that you are currently working on. By being able to keep track of task and workload, you are going to have a better chance of getting things done quickly and accurately. You are going to have the ability to keep track of everything. I mean it, everything that's going on, and you will that's going on, and you will be able to make sure that each task is announced for. What else? Not only that, but you are also going to see who is charge of what this task, and whether they have too many tasks or they can keep up. All of those things are going to make it easier for you to stay on the top of things. So this Gantt chart is very useful for our project. Next, you will be able to keep a track of timing, which is very important, because as we know, as engineer, time is money. We will track of timing and progresses that being made on a different task and categories within your overall project. This is going to make it a great deal easier for you to make sure you will hit the overall project deadline. The key for this is to make sure that you have each task assigned with the right deadline, and that each of your team members also is updating how far along they are on every pieces of task that they are assigned to. That way, you are that way, you and anyone else on the project can log in and immediately see how well you are doing in this project. Okay, now let's move to the next point, which is the type of task. As we know, Gantt chart, it's making relation between tasks. So for the type of task that we have in a Gantt chart, It's only four. The first one, which is finish to start. Second one, start to start. The third one, finish to finish. And the four is finish to start, which I mean, the task number, for example, the task number two is must start to finish the task number one. Okay. Yes. Let me give me an example for the finish and start relation. Like, if you are going to wash your car, okay, you should wash your car first and finish from washing. Then the dry you can dry your car, okay. So you can dry your car without finishing washing your car, okay. This is the first relation. The second relation is the start to start. Like if you are making your floor, okay, you should first mixing your concrete, and in the same time of mixing the concrete, you should prepare concrete for the floor, okay, so the concrete will not be damaged. The third relation that we have is finish to finish. Like if you are watching a match, okay, so the match progresses. So when the match is end, the broadcast of the match will end at the same time also. So this is the example for finish to finish. The last example, the last relation, sorry, which is it's confused for some people, like which is finish to start, or we can say start to finish. Like what? If you have a guard in your door, okay, or your camper, you have guards, okay? So, and you have also two shifts for this guard. The first shift must be end, it should the second shift start. So you can't finish the first shift without starting the second shift. So it's a relation between this task, and it's called start to finish, okay? And now I would like to go to see the snake blocker for Gentoo chart, okay? So let's exit from here and go to the MS project. Okay, for the MS project, as we see here, our task in the right, in the left, sorry, in the left hand side, these are the tasks that we have in our project. And as I said before, we have five summary tasks, which is the initiation process, planning process, and also we have the executing process, and also we have mentoring and controlling process. And the last one is the closing process. Okay, now I would like to, before I move on, this is the duration for our project, which is 31 days, okay? So now let's move to the, let's make it here, okay. Now let's move to the Gantt chart. As you see here, this is our Gantt chart. Let's go to the view, yes, view entire project, yes. Here is our Gantt chart for the project, okay? So it's very big, so I will minimize the screen here. We don't need the duration for the project. We only need the task for the project, okay. For the task for the project, please come here, okay. As you see here, the develop project charter is the most important task. Why? Because it's many tasks that is depend on it. For example, let's go, for example, yes, for identify stakeholders. As you see here, let's zoom in on. Okay. Perfect, here. Okay. Here is this is the first task, which is the development project charter. And the second one, which is the identify stakeholders, As you see here, this arrow is going to the identify stakeholders. So it this relation is finished to start, which is the first relation. The second one, we have the stakeholders also. It's related to many tasks. So what I mean, many tasks that depends on the identified stakeholders. So we can't working on the next task without finishing the first the first one and the second one. Okay, so as I mentioned, this is the first task and the second one, and this is the relation between them, which is the finish to start. Okay, now I would like to mention the second relation that we have, like this, which is the development project management plan. Development project management plan, as we see here in the proceeders. Okay, let's make it bigger. Yeah, it's depend on what identify stakeholders. Okay, so it is start to start. When sorry, it's collect requirement. Sorry, not development project management. Yeah, sorry, it's a collect requirement. In the collect requirement, it's depend on the development project management plan. So when is the development project plan task start? We can start on the collect requirement in the same time. The next relation that we have is yes. Not the next relation. I want to talk about now the critical path that we have. Okay. As you see here, I make 100% complete for this task because we finished already from this and we already presented to you, gentlemen. Okay. So when we remove this, as you see here, all of the critical path that we have is showing here. So as my friend mentioned in a critical path, it's very important for any project, okay? So any delay in the critical path will make your project finish late, except in finishing in the same time as you assume in the beginning of your project. So as you see here, let's make it here. Okay, as you see here, this is the critical path, and you can know it from the MS by going to the resources, no report, project, view. Yes, view. I think in view, or what? Or task. I forget where, sorry, but let me check. View. Yes, when you click in any task that you have, okay, you can go and this tool will appear immediately, okay, which is called format. Then you click on a critical task and you will see the critical path that you have in your project, okay? So this is the critical path that we have, okay? And as I said, I mentioned, critical path should not be have any delay, okay? So This is our critical path, okay? Every task it's related to another one. There's no task that it's not related to anything. All task is related on each one, okay? And I think that's all for our Gantt chart, okay? I would like to thank you, gentlemen, for your attention and for your listening. And I hope you are doing well. I would like to leave my mic now to my friend Yazid to complete the rest of our presentation. Thank you and see you soon.